I've compared Phil Heath from different Olympia contests, but never compared his arguably worst versions ever. And that is the 2014 Mr. Olympia versus the 2018 Mr. Olympia when he lost the title to Sean Rodden. In 2011, 12, and 13, Phil presented among the best and nearly flawless physiques on the Olympia stage. People thought that no one would be able to defeat this man until he himself decides to retire. Things, however, started to change when he came with a less impressive physique in 2014, with a bloated stomach that urged many fans and observers to claim that Kai Greene, who was placed second, should have won the title. Although he tried to get his midsection under control, the curse of the bloated stomach continued to haunt Phil until it cost him the title. So here comes Phil Heath between 2014 and 2018 Mr. Olympia. The front double biceps shows that he maintained the same biceps development. He is known for having among the best arms in his era. The noticeable difference, however, is his chest area. He definitely looks wider in 2014. The problem of spreading out in this pose became worse with time, and it shows in 2018. His lats look wider in 2014, due to the inability to spread out when hitting this pose. His thighs have always been among his most powerful areas, and they got more massive with time. You can notice the size added to the outer quads in 2018. Phil has never been known for hitting an impressive front lat spread due to his narrow structure. His lats are not that wide, but he makes it up with the density and the depth he shows in this area in the back poses. Although he looked way darker in 2018, I think he managed to replicate the same pose with better quads. The side chest is one of his most powerful poses. He makes use of his rounded and bubble-shaped chest, shoulders, and arms. This pose reflects his great conditioning with visible striations in the chest and the lower part, including the thighs and the glutes. The back has always been among his most impressive areas, which improved with time. Phil arguably has among the best back areas in bodybuilding history, along with Ronnie and Dorian. He maintained massive and ripped arms, rounded shoulders, and incredible traps. His 3D lats became even more shredded and ripped in 2018. His hamstrings and glutes are phenomenal, and he also maintained the same size in his calves. The rear lat spread shows that although Phil does not have the width of Rolly or Rami's lats, he makes it up with the phenomenal depth and density and the unmatched conditioning. Notice how ripped and defined he became in 2018. His massive traps became more defined and shredded. It looks like there are valleys under these traps, which became deeper with time, reflecting the improved conditioning in this area. Phil has among the best triceps. He is blessed with huge and ripped triceps, which form, along with his massive and peaky biceps and phenomenal forearms, among the best arms in his era. He maintained the same conditioning in his ripped chest, shoulders, and thighs, but we can easily notice his bloated stomach in 2014, which shockingly enough looks tighter in 2018, but perhaps this is only due to the time this shot was taken. The abs and thighs has always been among his least impressive poses, but it seems that he nearly replicated the pose. As you can see, his abs look ripped and tight, but the problem was in the breaks between the poses when he was breathing heavily and was struggling to keep his midsection tight, and that's when the bloated stomach came out. Phil is known for hitting among the most powerful, most muscular poses in his era, making use of his powerful traps and phenomenal shoulders and arms. He maintained the same size and the same conditioning in his shoulders and chest, with the line that splits his chest in half. Notice how impressive his upper chest is. His quads definitely became more massive in 2018 with the size he managed to add to this area. Although these arguably were Phil's least impressive or worst versions, he still maintained to present incredible conditioning. Some of his areas even became better, namely his back and thighs. The IFBB ignored his bloated stomach since 2014, but the pressure increased with top bodybuilders like Arnold openly criticizing and denouncing this problem, embarrassed the IFBB, and left them no choice but to strip Phil of his title. Let me know what you think about this matchup, and don't forget to subscribe, share, and like. Thanks for watching, and have a nice one.